Hi, we're Justice Productions.
And this is a keyframe document showing how our media product uses, develops, and challenges forms and conventions of real products.
The main product we use for comparison is the 2008 film Twilight, based on the book by Stephanie Meyer.
We'll now show you 6 clips from both Twilight and our product.
Oh God, I'm so sorry.
Honestly, it's okay.
It's just my phone was ringing. I wasn't looking where I was going. I didn't see.
Honestly, it's fine.
The first clip we see is the first meeting between the lead characters. In this, the females are both being saved from a crisis.
After the female has been saved from the crisis, there is a lingering moment between the two before both males make a hasty exit, leaving the females on their own. This is one of the conventions used in the romantic genre, as the same situation is seen in Twilight as well as our own film.
Let's try to focus while we check those out, huh, guys?
I've got to go. It was nice meeting you.
Mallory.
Goodbye, Mallory.
Soon after the two leads meet and some connection is established, the male makes a speedy exit, leaving the females confused and dazed.
I'm not really supposed to say anything about it.
Oh, hey, I can keep a secret.
really, it's just like an old scary story.
Well, I want to know. Sorry.
It's okay, don't worry about it. It's Alex, by the way.
Mallory.
In our film, the female lead meets another male character who saves them from a crisis. However, instead of suddenly leaving, the two talk and the mood of the scene is a positive one, leaving the lead female in the new equilibrium in accordance to Todorov's theory, which is implemented in many romantic films' narratives.
Thank you. Petrodrum.
Another convention of romantic films that we follow is moment of realisation or disruption. This is where a lead character discovers something about another character or an element of the storyline that was not clear to the lead character. However, it may be obvious to the audience. You can see this in both Twilight and our own film.
You're impossibly fast and strong. Your skin is pale white and ice cold. Your eyes change color. And sometimes you speak like you're from a different time. You never eat or drink anything. You don't go out in the sunlight. How old are you?
17.
How long have you been 17?
A while.
Looks like we're going to be here for some time, eh?
Are you stalking me or something?
It's just a coincidence, I guess.
I've never seen you around here before. And then suddenly, within a week, I've seen you three times. I mean, where are you from? Where are you going now? How did you get here?
What? Peter.
What?
Peter Edgerton.
Nice to meet you, Peter. What train did you say you would catch? In?
The confrontation. This sees the lead character challenge the other character of interest about their actions seen up to that point in the film. Again, this can be seen in our own film, as well as Twilight, and this is a convention widely used in many romantic films.
Alice lent me the dress. Cass is...
You're perfect. I'll take care of it, Chief Swan.
Uh-huh. I've heard that before. Bells? I put a new can of pepper spray in your bag.
Dad.
And, you look beautiful.
Thanks. See ya.
Oh God, I'm so sorry.
It's okay, don't worry about it. It's Alex, by the way.
Mallory.
Our final comparison is between the female leads gaining a new lease on life following Todorov's theory of equilibrium. Both females dress in the blue colour, which is a calming, rich colour that represents new beginnings.